affect someone with kidney issues or kidneys that function below normal? Yeah, I mean, it's really quite the opposite. I mean, vitamin D can help the kidneys, but more specifically, kidney disease can cause vitamin D deficiency. I would say it's more important to think of it that way. So a lot of questions coming in about vitamin K and vitamin K2 and taking vitamin K with vitamin D. Here's the reality. The whole thing about vitamin K and vitamin D and you have to have a certain combination or a certain ratio is way overblown clinically. A lot of people talk about it, but in the clinic, as it pertains to working with people one-on-one for almost 20 years, I don't see this to be the case at all. So I lean more toward the side of you don't necessarily need to be on vitamin K and vitamin D. Test it. Like, that's where it's at. Don't just take vitamin K in high doses and take vitamin D in high doses if you haven't had them tested. So measure your vitamin D levels, but also measure the vitamin K levels to see whether or not it's something you need to be supplementing with. But don't just take extra vitamin K. Remember, vitamin K, if you eat a lot of greens, if you eat a lot of vegetables, you're going to get lots of vitamin K. The other place we get vitamin K is from our microbiome. Okay, remember that about half of your daily need for vitamin K comes from the bacteria that live inside of you. They produce it for you. So this goes back to antibiotics, right? Antibiotics, a major one. If you've been on a lot of antibiotics, you've knocked out your flora and they're responsible for producing that vitamin K. So if you've got good flora and you eat lots of greens, don't worry so much about taking extra vitamin K and don't fear your arteries clogging with calcium because you can't get calcium into your bone without vitamin K. Although that is true, your vitamin K levels may be just fine, and taking more is not necessarily going to help it any better. So a couple of questions coming in about VDR, vitamin D receptor gene mutations. Those are other areas where clinically, and I don't know if you guys knew this about me, but I was one of the very first doctors, this was about 19 years ago, that brought DNA testing to the market. A company hired me to come out with select genes, and we created a handful of different genes that we wanted to bring to the market to offer SNP testing. And the VDR was one of those genes, but what we found as it played out over years of study and research, clinically speaking, is that VDR mutations really didn't have all that great of an impact, meaning if you had them, it didn't mean that you were going to have more vitamin D deficiency than the next person, and that your greatest risk for vitamin D deficiency was truly, well, I've erased it, was truly a lack of sunshine. Like, it didn't matter whether you had VDR mutation or whether you didn't have VDR SNP. It was the lack of sunshine that played the huge role and could correct the problem. Hey, if you've got a functional medicine or health question that you'd like me to answer for you, make sure you send me an email, glutenology@gmail.com, and we'll do our best to create a video answer just for you. Have a great day.